I moved here, and then I knew someone was out there, but I didn't know who, and I just signed up, you know.
I'm not a rich man. I can't give a lot of money to an organization, a charity or something. But I've had life experiences that I can share, I think, that are more valuable than just money. And if I can share those, if I can get a young man on the right road, I think anyone can do it.
You know, we were just going through some family difficulties, and so I don't think it was so much her that wanted it, but I could see a need for her to have some more one-on-one relationship with somebody that could maybe understand what she was going through at the time.
What was going on with your life?
Not much. Just kind of sitting around watching TV all the time, all day, not doing much, until Roger came along and then started doing a lot more, getting a lot more active.
You know, we reach one kid at a time, and this is the next generation, and that's what we should be putting our effort and concern and support into.
Because I'm a single mother, I don't do fishing and any of that outdoor stuff. I would not be skiing, snowboarding. And because of Scott, he's been able to do all those things.
You just show up. It's not complicated.
I do what I do, and I just take them along.
You just got to be there. You just got to show up for these kids and hang out. And we have a lot of fun. We have a lot of fun together.
I thought he was really mean at first, really strict, because never really had any guidance in my life before that. So when I finally had an authority figure, it was really weird for me.
All you got to do is share it a little bit, and it doesn't take a lot of time. You just put the kid in your back pocket and go do what you normally do. If you're going to work on your car, take the kid with you. If you're going to build something, a doghouse, a shed, take him with you.
Rochelle, when she was younger, she had a real hard time making friends, and so I thought this might be a good way for her to have a friend come and eat lunch with her and spend time, go out on the playground and play with her, because she didn't have a lot of friends when she was little.
They enjoy learning new things. So young men, so you don't have to be an educator, or you don't have to be a tremendously smart person. You just got to share your experiences, and I think that can help one, and if a lot more of us help one, there would be a lot less trouble we'd have on the streets.
Oh, absolutely. Her grades started going up because she found somebody that took an interest in her and just her, and didn't have to fight with her siblings over this one person that would spend time with her.
He's really matured a lot. He's just turned into very respectable young man. I mean, he's a real joy to be around. He's kind of like part of our family now.
It's just something that you almost get more back from it than you're giving, even though you're volunteering. It's just one of those that just makes you feel satisfied with your day, and that you were able to help somebody in a small way even.
And I think that's what makes this very special, is because I know that I'm helping. I know that what I'm doing is blessing her life, and that blesses me.
They used to have this really pretty golden retriever, and see, I didn't have a dog, so I thought that was just the coolest thing on the place of this earth, to have a dog. And throwing the ball around, wrestling around with the dog, and playing with Jonah and Micah, it's like heaven, you know?
There was a part during school when I was kind of slipping, and my life didn't really have much direction, but Roger helped me get through that, and he was always there for me. But now at Diamond, I'm getting good grades.
I'm a lot happier than I was. Before, I used to always be upset, and I didn't get along with anyone at my house. But now, because of her, I am somebody now.
Well, I think probably the biggest thing he's taught me is how to act like a responsible adult and take responsibility for everything that I do and just work hard. That's probably the most important thing.
I got friends now. It's all thanks to that woman. She's my inspiration.
Whenever I get older, I just want to remember how much he's been there for me, how much he's taught me. I don't think one single person has taught me any more than Roger has. So just want to remember everything about him.
I told him I wanted a little girl between 6 and 8, and I would like for that child to be African-American, black, or had some black blood in her. And because in Juneau, our children, especially our young black children, don't know their black side. And I wanted to just be that mentor and that part of their lives. And then they called 2 weeks later, and they said, "Sherry, it's as if she fell out from the sky just for you. We have a little girl, she's 7 years old, just moved here. She's gonna be staying with her dad, and we'd like to set up a meeting."
Just the Big Brothers Big Sisters program has said lots of names. So once they said Sherry Patterson, I thought, that's an interesting name. So I decided to just pick that name. And a week later, we met at a certain building by McDonald's. And you know, when she first walked through that door, I thought she looked so nice and proper. She's more than a friend. She's not really a normal human being. She's actually really unique to me. I really, you know, mainly share my feelings and ask her important questions, and I share what I'm doing in school a lot. The Big Brothers Big Sisters just ask me, and I pick Sherry Patterson, and she has taught me that I'm really special ever since. Like a long, lonely string, I keep running toward to dream, moving on, moving on. Like a branch on a tree, I keep reaching to be free, moving on, moving on. There's a place in the sun where there's hope for everyone, where my poor, restless heart scattered around. There's a place in the sun, and before my life is done, gotta find me a place in the sun.
Very good.
That's part of it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I want you to always remember, yes, ma'am.